Hey friends, hope everybody is having an absolute amazing day. I'm super excited about what God is doing. He's doing so many powerful things right now. I've never in my life seen more people who are moving forward in their God dreams. I've never seen more people move forward in what the Lord has for them. That's why it's such an exciting time to be alive. There's so many people who are moving forward in their God dreams. So many people are moving forward in their God destinies. I see so many people launching business ideas. I see so many people who God is accelerating at a very, very fast pace. So that's what I'm super excited and stirred about today. Andrew, what's going on, my man?
We are here. We got it fixed.
Amen. Man, the Lord is good. We're going to dive into this. I'm going to ask everybody watching right now at the very first of this video, go ahead and share this video right now so people can get on here, because we're going to help some people accelerate in what God has called them to do. So I was just talking to Andrew the other day just about the Lord, what he's speaking to both of us about. And the word acceleration, the Lord's given both of us that word. So, man, I'm just going to turn it over to you just tell everybody what the Lord's been speaking to you about.
Well, I'm so excited to be doing this broadcast with you today. I'm welcome all our guests. You know, the word acceleration is something that the Lord's been really speaking to me for the last year. To accelerate means to cause to go faster or greater activity. It means development, progress, advancement. And that's something that sticks out to me, advancement. Because it's time for us to advance in our purpose. It's time to go accelerate, to cause speed, to go faster. Some of you have been on pause today. It's been like everything's just been at a slow motion, but God is about to propel you into a fast forward motion. God's going to skip over some things. I believe some steps are going to be skipped over so that you come into the manifestation of his promises. One thing that the Lord, we've been doing a series here at our church for the month of September on birthing, because he spoke to me and he said, get ready to birth multiple miracles. He said, plural, not just one, but multiple miracles. And he said, this month, September, which is the ninth month, and we all know it takes 9 months to birth a baby. Right. Some of you are going to be birthing babies that it's taken 10 years to do. There's going to be a divine acceleration, and you're going to go into labor. Even today, watching this broadcast right now, yes. I just prophesy to somebody, it's your day to birth the manifestation of the promise. You've been delayed long enough. You've been on a pause long enough, but it is time to give birth to that promise. He said, even as I spoke to Abraham, at the appointed time, Sarah would give birth. Abraham laughed. Then Sarah laughed. It's your time to laugh again. You've been so serious. You've been crying long enough. It's time to laugh, because what God is going to birth is going to be so ridiculous, outrageous, beyond anything you've ever dreamed possible. God said, I'm going to exceed your expectation. He said, I'm changing your name from Abram to Abraham. You're going to be a father of many nations, and I'm going to do it quickly. You say, well, it's going to take 10 years for me to birth what God has promised me. No, not when God begins to accelerate things. I just hear a name change in the spirit. Some of you are going from Abram to Abraham, from Sarah to Sarah. I'm going to birth it. Isaiah 61:7 says, instead of shame, you shall receive a double portion. Get ready to birth double. Multiple miracles, multiple breakthroughs for your life. He said, with this breakthrough, your name is going to change. You're going from a singular breakthrough to multiple miracles. I'm enlarging the vision. I'm enlarging my covenant promise with you. It is the set time of birthing and manifestation of even old promises. You've been pregnant for so long, you don't know. You thought maybe it had been aborted. It's not too late. You're in a set time this morning. And that's why I keep hearing the Lord just say, I agree with you, an acceleration for the assignment. We've been on delay, but God says everywhere the soles of our feet go, we possess the land. And it's time for us to start possessing. We've been staring at it. We've been looking at it, thinking maybe someday or maybe one day. But God says, why not now? We are moving into a now. I know both of you and I have been prophesying about a now season. In fact, I'm writing a book right now about the now season. It is time for the now. It's not a one day. It's not a someday. The difference between a new season and a now season, a new season is just another season. A now season mm-hmm. is where the promises begin to manifest. And I believe you're about to embrace the baby. You're about to embrace the promise. You have anything to add on that?
You know, one thing the Lord told me last week was to tell people to go through your prayer journal, get your old prophetic words, and learn to fight with them. And what happens is the enemy comes in and tries to bring something against the word of God over your life. And when you have them written down, you can look at them. You have journals of them, and you can sit back and say, devil, that does not align with the prophetic word of God. It may have been given to me 10 years ago, but it's going to come to pass. It may have been given to me 5 years ago, and the enemy tried to steal it, but it's going to come to pass. So hush your mouth, devil. I'm going to accomplish everything that God has called me to do. And we got to believe the prophetic word over our life, the word of God from that the Lord has given us, and then from prophets and apostles who spoke a word into us. You got to believe in the prophetic word over your life more than what the enemy is trying to say. And a prophetic word I got recently was the word AIM, A-I-M. And the Lord said acceleration, impartation, and manifestation. And Andrew, the way the Lord showed it to me is there's an acceleration in this season. We were in a past season, but get to this new season, this next season, there's an acceleration. And on the acceleration, what is going to happen is impartation is going to happen to us. See, in the past season, we got the prophetic word, but in this season, we get the wisdom to steward the word. We get the insight. We get the knowledge. The right leaders come around us. The right person with the administration gift comes alongside us. See, a lot of times we're moving and operating, and then the person with the gifts of help in the Bible, we don't like to talk about the gifts of help and administration a whole lot.
Right.
But the people, let me tell you who the real heroes are in ministry. The people that have the gifts of administration helps. Thank you, Jesus, for them.
Yes.
They're going to come alongside your prophetic word from your past season. And with their gifts alongside of what we're called to do, that will make it a now season. And then all of a sudden, a financier is going to come by and say, you know, I want to join your ministry. I want to sow into your ministry. They're going to write checks. In the last season, you didn't have the finances to do what you can do now. You didn't have the right leaders around you, but now you got the right leaders. God is strategically putting people in place. Acceleration, the impartation from that causes the manifestation.
Come on.
It is the birthing of the baby. And when the baby comes out, it is manifested. Everybody can see the end result then. And every person who raised their mouth up against you, their words will prove to be a liar. I'm not saying that negatively, because people say, well, everybody said something negative about you, but here is the manifestation of the promise that God gave me. See, I know that there's a lot of people on here. You've been called to entrepreneur business, and you're still sitting there making somebody else rich. Now, thank God for your job. You prayed for it, but that was your past season. You're scared to step into your now season, your acceleration season. You've been in ministry a long time, but you've never launched your own work. This is your time. You know, some of you single people, you got to quit being scared, dude. You got to ask her out. This is your season to have an acceleration. And I want to speak to somebody who has not been able to have kids yet. You've tried, you may have even went to a doctor. I'm telling you, go natural. This is your now season. The child will come forth. I'm talking a natural baby. Hold it in your arms. Some of your ministries, you may have tried in the past season. It didn't work. This is a now season. There's something different upon it. You've got to try, because the acceleration of God is going to water that seed. The fertilizer is going to come. The favor of God. And now let me explain this. Some of you have tried something in the past season, but you didn't have the favor. You didn't have the wisdom. You didn't have all the insight that you got now. Some of you need to pick that old dream back up and try again. This is your season, and you will see it manifested right before your eyes. What you've seen in the spirit, you will hold in the natural. I'm going to let you go, because I can go for a minute, brother.
Come on. You know, this week I was preaching a message on Hannah. And, you know, the different things that she went through. She always had a Penina, the words that she went yearly to worship. And she was provoked sore by her adversary. Have you ever seen everyone else enjoying the promises that you desire so bad and so deep within you, and they're enjoying it, and you look off and you think, God, I feel left out. Maybe that's for everybody else. Maybe everybody else is called to a ministry. Maybe everybody else is called to have a natural child, and I'm not called to have a natural child. But God said, I made you a promise, Hannah. And when she got so tired of year after year, Penina just kept birthing out those babies and rubbing it in her face. And she was sitting there saying, I feel forgotten. I feel forsaken. Then finally she went to the house of God. And the word says that she poured out her soul. She wept bitterly, and her mouth moved, but no sound came out of it. Have you ever been in a place where you are just in such mourning that you're weeping and you have no sound left? You have no more tears to cry because you've been in that place for so long. And the word says that she began to pour out her soul. And when she did, she knew it was finished. See, there comes a time when you know that you've gotten through to heaven and you know you've gotten an answer. And then she knew Elkanah, her husband, and she became pregnant with the promise. Now, see, something is very challenging. When God wants to birth the prophetic in your life, or he wants to give you a Samuel, it's going to take a little more time than it takes for Penina to birth out her babies.
Come on.
When God gives you a promise. See, some of you have been promised something from years ago, and it's yet to come to pass. Maybe you tried what Apostle was prophesying about. Maybe you tried at an earlier season, but you didn't have the favor. You didn't have the manifestation coming on it. You didn't have the approval of God on it. So you pre-launched like Moses. You were trying to rescue your people, but you ended up on the backside of the desert. I believe today you're going to have an encounter with fire. I believe today that we are burning bushes speaking to you. Try again. It's your time to get back up. It's your time to go forth. God has called you to be a deliverer. God has called you for such a time as this. And Hannah conceived a Samuel. See, when you conceive the prophetic, the great prophet of Israel, the one who anointed kings and ruled nations and heard from God, when you birth a baby like that, it's going to take a little more time. It's going to take a little more development. It's going to take a little bit more time being on the backside of the desert. But when you come forth this time, you're coming forth with the favor of God and the hand of God on your life. You better get ready for Red Seas to part. You better get ready for plagues to come on those that come against you. You better get ready for enemies to be drowned in the sea, because God says, I am launching you in this day and in this hour. You are being propelled forward. You are beginning to accelerate. You are gaining speed. Even as you are watching this broadcast right now, you are going into greater activity. God says, I'm speeding some things up, but I had to bring the right alignment. See, some of you have been connected to the wrong thing that's been holding you back, and you've been trying to run, you've been trying to go forward, you've been trying to speed up, but you're connected to something that's wrong. God says, I'm bringing divine alignment. Just like on a car, if you want to go fast, you got to make sure your wheels are in alignment. You got to make sure your steering is in alignment, or you can't go fast, and you've got to shift gears. God says, I'm shifting you out of slow motion into fast motion. I'm shipping you out of delay. I'm shifting you into acceleration, 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 acceleration. Some of you need to open up your mouth and begin to prophesy right now. I am moving into acceleration. I am moving into impartation. I am moving into manifestation. I declare my promises are manifesting now. Know that God has heard your cry. He has heard your tears. He has seen you, how you've been provoked sore, Hannah, but you are going to give birth to the prophetic thing in your life. Those words of God will not return void, but they will accomplish what God has sent them for. And God has impregnated you with a vision. He's impregnated you with a word. And I hear fire on what you were just speaking about earlier. Some of you may have not been able to give birth to a natural children. You know, my wife and I struggled to have a baby. We went through many miscarriages. She had a condition. They said it would be very difficult for her to get pregnant. But we had a promise from God, and we stood on that promise. And we went through many miscarriages, three or four miscarriages, broke our hearts every time. And I remember the last one, I had met with our church. It was Father's Day weekend. And we finally announced that we were pregnant because we thought we were in the safety zone to have our baby. And that night after we announced it, my wife, about 2:30 in the morning, miscarried the baby. And at that point, I felt like giving up. I felt like, God, I'm okay if we never have the promise, like the woman that the prophet prophesied. She doesn't have a baby, and she said, no, don't say that to me, because sometimes it hurts to even want that anymore. It hurts to even desire that, because you face disappointment after disappointment. And it's like, don't say that to me again. Don't get my hopes up. Even maybe you're watching this today and you're saying, don't get my hopes up. But I'm telling you, get your hopes up, because God is not going to disappoint you. Get your hopes up and start believing again. Start getting out your promises. Start declaring the word of God. Say, God, you made me promises. I stand on your word. I pray over my promises. I declare those words. Get out your prophecies that have been written down. The other day, I got out some prophecies that I have on CD that I knew were from God. And I just started playing them in my spirit. And I started saying, God, remember what you promised. Remember what you said. See, some of you today, you're like Noah. You've been in the ark of protection. But the scripture says, I believe it's in Genesis chapter 8, verse 1, and it says, and the Lord remembered Noah. He hasn't forgotten that you're in the ark. He hasn't forgotten that you've been in a place surrounded by smelly animals and that it feels like you're never coming out. You're never coming into your promise. But God says, I'm remembering you. I'm moving towards you through my covenant promises. And I have kept you. I have protected you. I have caused you not to pre-launch and mess everything up. And now I'm bringing acceleration to that. You're coming out of the ark, Noah. You're coming into your promises. I just feel this like fire. You go ahead and you begin prophesying, because I know you got something in you.
Man, it's funny. Somebody messaged me the other day and they said, man, I caught one of your videos and I loved it, man. When did you start preaching recently? I mean, how come I never heard of you? I said, I've been doing this for 23 years. It's just all of a sudden, now it is my time. Now it is my season. And there is an acceleration. There is an advancing coming to so many people. You've been doing stuff on the backside of the desert, but now it's about to be your time of promotion. I felt the Lord gave me a powerful prophetic word recently. And I had this, it was like a vision. And I saw all these soldiers fighting. And the Lord yells, get in the bunker and cover your head. And then a blast went. And a lot of people were still fighting. And what happened is they were destroyed. And the Lord said, the ones not hearing my voice will be destroyed. But because you spent a season in a bunker, in a place of prayer, with your head bowed down, seeking God, now it's time to get up and move. And I don't know who I'm talking to, but you feel like God has passed you by. God gave me a prophetic word recently called silent treatment. And here's the word. So many people think that heaven is being silent on their behalf, but it's not. They've just been preparing something. When you want to shoot an arrow further, you pull it back further.
Come on.
And what has happened in that vision I had, the Lord was telling people, don't go out there now. I need you to spend a season in prayer. The ones who aren't listening to the Lord, there's people right now that are moving, trying to make things happen, but they need to be in the place of prayer. There is a remnant of people. Listen, there has never been more kingdom-minded people in America than there is right now. That's why the enemy does not have a shot at America, because the kingdom-minded people, there's 7,000 that have not bowed a knee to Baal, and they're coming out of the cave. They're coming out of the woodwork. They're coming out, and they're reconnecting. See, Andrew, let me dip back 12 years ago. I was in prayer, and I said, God, America needs a revival. And the Lord said, I want a bunch of John the Baptist who will go out in the middle of the wilderness where nobody sees them, and they pray and they fast, and they're preaching and speaking the truth. But it will be years down the road before their voices are elevated, before their businesses are elevated, but before they are put on a bigger platform, before they get that promotion at the factory, before their business in their city actually takes off and they get extreme favor in the city, before they get that job at the recovery center. Well, what if people are getting promoted right now for God to use in an extreme way. You thought you were forgotten for 20 years, baby, but you stayed in the place of prayer. You were in the place of prayer. And God was like, if you can pray a little bit longer, your time is coming. Your acceleration is coming. And now that the acceleration is coming, the impartation is coming. And what you did not have to be successful in the last season, you got it now, child. And now you're about to walk out. And when it is manifested, even the atheists are going to be like, woo! God must be real, because that person is walking in a blessing and a favor that no man could give them. And, you know, it is the illustration that God is looking for. God wants to use some people as an illustration because everybody said what you went through could have killed you. But now look at you. You went through all of this, but now look at what you got. All these people came against you, but now look at what you got. Your last five businesses failed, but now you're a millionaire. How did you have it? God brought me through. Won't he do it, y'all? Won't he do it? Go ahead, man.
You know, it's what you were saying about the cave. The Lord has been showing me, and one of my favorite men of God in the Bible, of course, is David, because he was a worshiper and a warrior. There's nothing feminine about being a worshiper. You can be a worshiper and a warrior. In fact, that's one of the most masculine things you can do is lead your family into worship. Mm-hmm. But he wasn't developed, in the palace. He was developed in the cave, hiding out from Saul, the spirit of Saul trying to assassinate him. And I remember one season of my life, I was in a cave. I was being hidden. And, that's frustrating sometimes when you're being mm-hmm. hidden. You're thinking, God, I have so much in me. I want to be used of God. I want, give me an opportunity. And growing up, I sang gospel music, and I had doors opening for me when I was 12 and 13 and 14 years old. And then suddenly when I started preaching, it was like zero things happened. I mean, for 1 year's time, I didn't have any invitations. And I remember crying out to God saying, God, what's going on? He said, I'm hiding you in a cave so that you can emerge. And when you emerge, that you will have something to say. See, it's during that time of intimacy, hiding out in the caves. I believe right now we're calling some people out of your cave season. Mm-hmm. You've been in a cave. You've been locked away. You've been hidden away. But God says, I've been sheltering you for protection. Because now when you emerge, you're coming out with fire. You're coming mm-hmm. out with power. And only through that intimacy or through that intimate time will you birth. See, it requires intimacy to birth something. And God says, I don't want you to be intimate with ministry. I don't want you to be intimate with a business. I want you to be intimate with me. And then I will download heavenly mm-hmm. strategic blueprints for you to move out and accomplish my will and purpose. But through intimacy in the secret place. See, Hannah had to run to that secret place with God so that she could be impregnated with the Samuel or the prophetic word from the Lord. I don't want to hear what man's philosophies are. I don't want to hear man's wisdom. I want to hear a word from heaven. I want to hear a throne room word. I want to hear what the secret place is saying. I want to hear what God is saying because I want to be impregnated with something of the spirit, not something of the flesh. I want something of the spirit. And I just feel right now that we need to encourage those that have been in a cave hiding. And maybe God has locked you away for a season, but there will be a season where you begin to emerge and God begins to lift you up out of the dunghill, out of the attack, out of the persecution from man. Maybe you say, God, I'm happy on the backside of the desert. Moses was pretty content on the backside of the mm-hmm. desert. He married, he was being a shepherd, and then he has this encounter with a burning bush, and he says, he gives all the excuses of why he can't do this and why he shouldn't do this. Some of you have been making excuses to God. God, I can't work with young people. I can't prophesy because I'm too intimidated. I can't mm-hmm. stand up before people because I don't want them looking at me. Well, let me tell you, God says, I'll bring you out of your comfort zone, and it won't be your natural man, but it'll be something supernatural. I don't have a college education. It doesn't matter as long as you have a blueprint from heaven. God says, I will raise you up. And I just hear that strong in my spirit right now that some people are coming out of a cave season, and it's a season for emerging. He said, like Joseph, you've been hidden away in a pit and you've been hidden away in a prison, but God says, I'm going to cause a butler to remember you that's going to open the door. What does a butler do? A butler opens the door for somebody, and God says, a butler is going to remember you, and the door is going to open, and you are going to walk through a new season mm-hmm. of your life like never before. This is going to be the greatest season. Just prepare yourself for the blessings of God. Begin to make room for God to bless you. Begin to stretch yourself. Those that are believing for a spouse, clear out a space in your closet and say, I thank you this year that you are bringing my spouse to come into my life. If you're believing for a baby, start believing God. Start buying things. My wife and I, we went and bought things for our daughter. she knew she wanted a girl, and so she went and bought things for our daughter. And yes, it was heartbreaking when we suffered those miscarriages, but we had a promise from God that he would give us the desires of our heart. So we began to put up a place in a room for her. We began to put up things, and when she came to pass, we had all of these things already prepared for her. Some of you need to make room for God to bless you, because you are moving into a season of acceleration. You can't catch up once you're there. You need to make room now, because when you hit that season, you're going to take off running, and you need to be prepared now. Start feeding yourself the word of God. Start getting in that intimate place with God. So when that door of ministry opens, you're not saying, oh God, what are you hearing? What are you hearing? No, you've trained your ear to hear the voice of God.
Amen. Man, that is so point. And it's just right on point with just what the Lord is doing. And I'm telling you, I have never seen more people start moving forward at such an accelerated pace. I'm seeing just in ministry, in life, in marriage, and what God is doing in America right now is so super encouraging. And I'm seeing so many people that are moving forward in everything that God has called them to do. And it is exciting when you're running with people who are all moving together at such a rapid, fast pace. And this is a season. It's an all-in season. It's a season that you don't need to be, well, maybe this is it, maybe that. No. This is the time. And a lot of people, God will put a dream, a purpose, a destiny on your heart, and then you'll say, well, God, if it's your will. No, he put it in your spirit because it was his will, it was his purpose, and it is your God-given dream. This is the season that you need to move forward, because there is the wind of God. My wife and I, over the past 6 weeks, we've launched two brand new websites because we knew God said now is the time. That we're launching new ministry, and the Lord says now is the time. This is our all-in moment. We are going for it like we have never gone after it in all of our life. We are all in 100% in every aspect of our life. We are fully going for the things of God. And I encourage everybody, this is your season to go for it. Man, go ahead and if you have any closing remarks, and tell people how they can connect with you.
Well, you can connect with us, of course, on Facebook and Instagram. It's Andrew Tao, T-O-W-E. I know it sounds spelled like toe. Most people say Andrew Toe, but it's Tao. Also, ramp.church is our website. We stream our services, Ramp Church Chattanooga. One last thing I want to leave with the people is the other day I was sitting in a room. I was just sitting there, and I heard the Lord speak to me, and he said, full speed ahead. And I said, okay, what do you mean? So I looked up the term. Come on, dictionary.com is your friend, and Google. I just said, what does that term mean? And it says that, I looked it up, it means that one should proceed with as much speed and energy as possible. No more delay. No more holding back. No more putting it off till tomorrow, like you were saying, one day it'll come. No, walk in the now. It's today. No more delay. And so I just want to agree. I just want to pray over the people. If I can have just a moment just to pray over the people. God, I pray over those that are watching live and those that will watch the replay. I am praying, God, that the spirit of delay or the hindrance of delay be broken over their life. I thank you for an acceleration. I thank you that they are going into a higher gear. You are shifting the gears of acceleration, and they will go full speed ahead. No more lack. No more drought, no more barrenness, but they are coming into the fullness of God's plan. I decree it and I declare it over them, and it is so in the name of Jesus.
In the name of Jesus. It's so funny. Somebody had a prophetic word Sunday at Roar Church that the drought is over, that the drought is over to move forward.
Yes.
And I want to tell you about two new ministries my wife and I started. RoarU.TV, Apostolic Prophetic training videos, blogs, and also people say, talk about marriage and parenting. So we are. We started a new YouTube and also a website called livingourbestlife.net. YouTube, it is the Dawson Best Life, and they've got videos on marriage and parenting. I want to see awakening in the family. And of course, you can go to jojodawson.net, find everything about us. Well, I appreciate y'all being on here with us. And we're going to do this again, man. This was fun.
Come on. I loved it. Thank you for having me.
Oh, yeah. We'll do it again. And everybody, you'll have a blessed day. And follow them at the Ramp Chat. Great things are happening. And I just even believe, as I was praying for you guys, that greater's coming. That,
yes,
man, you're just running
with. Can't
wait
for you to be with us in November.
Yeah, November 4th is going to be an amazing
awesome
time.
Yes, yes.
And I got a feeling you're going to be in Texarkana before long, my friend.
Come on.